हाउ आर यू बिलाल?
यस
ओके, आर यू नाइट, आर यू ओके?
सर, यस सर, ओके।
टुडे इज रिवीजन डे एंड टुमारो इज
यस सर।
यू आर कॉन्शियस अबाउट इट? वी हैव कंप्लीटेड टॉपिक्स पाकिस्तान habits, knowledge, I mean to say discussions, I think so. Pakistan habits, discussions. We have done three topics. Mel Bilal, do you have in your record these things already? We also completed to self-introduction. Yes, Bilal. Do you listen me?
Yes, sir, listening.
Yeah, okay. Let us start now revision. Just you have to, okay, refresh all things in your mind. Then just I start revision, okay, after 1 minute. Just you have to, okay, revise all things in your mind.
Okay, sir.
Okay, you have to open and main points you have to, fresh up in your mind. Okay? All main points regarding Pakistan habits and discussions. Yes, Bilal, let us start revision, okay? From Pakistan.
Yes, sir.
Pakistan made on 14th August 1947, Pakistan Muslim country. Qaid Azam was founder of Pakistan. Khan Lakhdari Khan was the first prime minister of Pakistan. The national language of Pakistan is Urdu. The national dress of Pakistan is Shalwar suit. Pakistan has four seasons. There are two colors of flag of Pakistan with moon and star. The green color shows that Muslims are in majority in Pakistan, and white color means non-Muslims in Pakistan. Moon means prosperity, and the star means success. Pakistan made on the base of Kalma. Pakistan made during the holy month of Ramadan. The old capital of Pakistan was Karachi. The latest capital of Pakistan is Islamabad. Pakistan is atomic power in Muslim world. Pakistan is only one atomic power in the Muslim countries. Next, background of Pakistan, in which situation Pakistan made, what were circumstances. In the subcontinent, there were two main nations, Hindus and Muslims. Muslims ruled in the subcontinent for many centuries. All nations were subordinate of Muslims. In 1857, British rulers captured a subcontinent and Hindus cooperated with them. Hindus learned English language and Hindus got good jobs in the subcontinent. Hindus got prosperity by cooperation with British rulers. On the other hand, Muslims were very hopeless and disappointed. Muslims hated from British rulers and also hated from English language. As a result, Muslims were very poor and Muslims were victim of poverty in the subcontinent. There was hopelessness in the Muslims. At that time, Sir Syed Ahmed Khan observed this situation and he wrote many books, and by writings he told to Muslims that you hate from British rulers, but you don't hate from English language if you want to get success or prosperity. He also said that if you have to get your basic rights, then you have to learn English language by all means. For this purpose, he opened Aligarh Guardian, Aligarh University, and a large number of Muslims got higher education and learned English language from there. When Muslims got prosperity in the subcontinent, then Muslims got good jobs. When Muslims learned English language, then Muslims made financially strong in the subcontinent. Then all Pakistan Muslim League made, and Qaiz Azam was president of all Pakistan Muslim League. On 23rd March in 1940, Pakistan resolution passed, and Pakistan movement started. And by struggle, Pakistan got independence on 14th August 1947. Qaiz Azam, he was the founder of Pakistan. He told to British rulers, he realized to British rulers, it is impossible to stay together for Muslims and Hindus nations together, because everything was quite different from each other. It was impossible to stay together for Muslims and Hindus to stay together in the subcontinent. The British rulers understood this point, and by struggle at last Pakistan got independence on 14th August 1947. It was the background of Pakistan. Now, what is the importance of Pakistan for us as a Pakistani? First of all, we born in Pakistan. Our forefathers offered many sacrifices for Pakistan. We can't ignore to Pakistan as a Pakistani. We have our separate identity as Pakistani. We have our separate ID cards as a Pakistani. We have our separate passports as a Pakistani. Pakistan is very important for us. We have liberty in Pakistan. We can go anywhere in Pakistan. We can spend our lives according to our choice in Pakistan. So Pakistan is very important for us. We spent our childhood in Pakistan. We got early education in Pakistan. We got higher education in Pakistan. We do jobs in Pakistan. We do business in Pakistan. So nobody can ignore to Pakistan as a Pakistani. Next point, problems. Pakistan is an underdeveloped country. Pakistan is a poor country. Pakistan is a victim of poverty. First of all, main problem is illiteracy in Pakistan. Most people are uneducated. Most people have not education. Most people live in the villages. A large number of people live in the villages. And in villages, there are not educational facilities, not many schools, not many colleges, not many universities, not many academies, and not many institutes. As a result, mostly people are illiterate in the villages. In the whole country, education is very expensive. Most people can't afford the fee. As a result, most people are illiterate in Pakistan. First of all, education problem, then water problem. Pakistan has few dams. Population is too much in Pakistan. Unemployment is going on peak in Pakistan. Crimes are too much in Pakistan. The law and order situation is not good in Pakistan. We have health problem. There are few hospitals in Pakistan, especially in villages. No medical facilities are available. Even in cities, not many hospitals, and our population is too much. Mostly people have to die without treatment in Pakistan. We have not proper medical facilities. That's a problem in Pakistan. On the other hand, corruption is very important problem in Pakistan. Most people are corrupt in Pakistan. Corruption is going on peak in Pakistan. Most people are cheaters in Pakistan. It's not good sign for us. These are problems in Pakistan now. Recommendation and cheating is very common. Bribe is very common in Pakistan. Fraud is very common in Pakistan. These are problems in Pakistan. Next point. Tragedy in Pakistan. When Pakistan got independence on 14th August in 1947, after 1 year, in 1948, two tragedies took place. First of all, founder of Pakistan was tied on 11th September 1948, and in the same year, Pakistan lost Kashmir. In 1951, first Prime Minister of Pakistan, Khan Lakhdar Khan, was killed at Chakrat Bagh in Rawalpindi. In 1971, Pakistan broke in two parts. Pakistan lost East Pakistan. On 8th October in 2005, earthquake came in Pakistan and mostly people were died as a result. In 1979, Zulfiqar Ali Bhutto, as the Prime Minister of Pakistan, who started an atomic program. So he was hung up in fake murder case. These are tragedies took place in Pakistan. Now I have tell you about achievements of Pakistan. First of all, Pakistan made, it is God gifted. Pakistan made during the holy month of Ramadan, Pakistan made on the base of Kalma. Pakistan won the war with India in 1965. Pakistan was winner in the war of 1965 with India. India is big country, and Pakistan is small country. Instead of Pakistan won the war with India. Certainly it was achievement. Further, Pakistan started atomic program in 1974. Malala Yousafzai played active role in the field of education as a Pakistani girl. Pakistan won Cricket World Cup in 1992 under the supervision under the supervision of later Prime Minister of Pakistan, Imran Khan, Pakistan made world champion in hockey. Pakistan made world champion in squash. Arifa Karim made world record in the field of IT in the age of just 16 years. She was quite young at that time, and she made world record in the field of IT. She made software, and her name was written or mentioned in the Guinness Book of Record. In the Guinness Book of Record, all world records are written or mentioned. These were all achievements. Pakistan announced as atomic power by 7 atomic experiments on 28th May in 1998 at Chagi in Rajasthan. These were all achievements. Now, next point, suggestions. How we can develop Pakistan, how we can promote to Pakistan. First of all, we should be honest. We have to stop the corruption in Pakistan. Many schools, many colleges, many universities, many academies and institutes should open in the whole country. Special government should focus to villages, and private sector should focus to villages. Education should be cheap. Education is very expensive, and education should be cheap in Pakistan, then when most people can get education easily. Many hospitals are required in the whole country. We need many hospitals. Then most people have to get treatment. Most people can make healthy. Government should take serious step in the health sector. Government have to make many dams in the country. Government have to create many opportunities for jobs for unemployed people. As a Muslim, we have to act on teachings of Islam, then everything will be okay. We need unity. We should not speak against Pakistan. We should be positive minded. We should not be negative minded. We should respect our country. If you respect our country, then everybody will respect our country. We should act to Allah. We have to act to Holy Quran. We should follow to Holy Quran. We should follow to Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. We should follow to Hadith. We should follow to Sunnah as a Muslim. Everything will be okay in Pakistan. We should follow to our leaders. We need hard work for Pakistan with honesty. As Karan said, if we want their success, we need unity, faith, and discipline. In that, my point of view, Pakistan is everything for us. We should be ready for all sacrifices in favor of our dear homeland. Next topic, habits. What are habits? Our routine works are called habits. Our daily activities are called habits. If we have to do any work on daily basis, it is called habit. Our all activities on daily basis are called habits. Next one, importance of habits. Nobody can deny the importance of habits. Habits have great importance in our lives. All human beings in the world have habits. All people in the world have habits. Nobody can deny the importance of habits except mad person. Habits are part of our lives. Habits play a major role in our lives. Habits have great importance in our lives. Habits are part of our lives. Nobody can ignore two habits. Next point, types of kinds of habits. There are two main types of kinds of habits, good habits and bad habits. What are good habits? Good habits. We get up in the morning. And if we offer our prayers, if we are punctual, if we drink much water, if we brush our teeth daily, if we take bath daily, if we take care about neatness, if we have to wear neat and clean dress, if we have to speak politely, if we have to speak English too much, if we have to listen to scholars, if we act on teachings of Islam, if we avoid from bad company, if we go for sleep early, if we don't kill our time, if we plan our lives, if we speak the truth, if we have to, we avoid from drugs, if we study daily, if we don't speak too much, we listen too much, but we speak less, good habits. Respect our parents and teachers. These are all good habits. What are bad habits? If we don't get up early in the morning, if we don't offer our prayers, if we don't recite the Holy Quran daily, if we don't go for morning walk daily, if we speak a lie, if we don't respect our parents and teachers, if we join to bad company, if we kill our time, if we don't plan our lives, if we don't brush our teeth daily, if we don't care about neatness, if we go for sleep too late, if we get up not early in the morning, if we get up too late, if we speak too much, if we don't study daily, if we don't follow two teachings of Islam, if we don't drink much water, if we take drugs, if we do smoking, if we don't fulfill our commitments, if we don't fulfill our promises, if we don't wear the neat and clean dress, these are all bad habits. Next, problems. Why most people have to adopt bad habits? First of all, environment plays major role. Nowadays, internet is very common. Everybody has cell phone. People have to be busy on cell phones all times. People have to be busy on internet all times. People have to kill their time. Further problems that people don't follow the teachings of Islam. People ignore the teachings of Islam. As a result, overall, environment is very bad, and because environment is not good, so most people have to adopt bad habits, and most people don't adopt good habits. Further problems, parents don't devote their attention on children. On the other hand, teachers don't devote their attention on children. People have to use internet for negative purposes. People have no routines, no timetable, no schedule. There are problems. So most people have to adopt good. Most people have not adopt good habits and adopt bad habits in this situation. Next one, suggestions. How we can adopt good habits? First of all, we should act on teachings of Islam as a Muslim. Yeah, people have to belong from different religions, but people have to follow their religions. And on the other hand, we should, you know, that we should get up in the morning. We need planning. We should study daily. We should worship daily. We should study to our holy books daily. We should read to our holy books daily. We should not speak too much. We should speak the truth. We should not speak a lie. We should join to good company. We should make good friends. We should not kill our time. We should obey to our parents and teachers. We should speak too much English. We should listen to English. We should study to English books. We should go to library daily. We should use internet, but not all times. We should use internet for 1 to 2 hours daily. It is enough. But for educational purpose, we can use internet. But we should not use internet all times for negative activities. We should avoid from smoking. We should not take drugs. We should be punctual. We should be hardworking. We should be honest. We should listen to scholars. These are all good, you know, they are all suggestions. In the end, my point of view, as a Muslim, just we have to act on teachings of Islam. We follow to Holy Quran, Holy Prophet, peace be upon him. And people have to belong to other religions, have to follow their religions. Inshallah, all people have to adopt good habits, and all people have to give up all bad habits. Next topic, discussions. What is discussion? If we talk in detail with somebody about any topic, it is called discussion. If we discuss with anybody, with any person in detail, it is called discussion. If we talk with logics and arguments with somebody in detail, so it is called discussion. Next, what is the importance of discussions? Discussions are very important for us. We have to solve our problems by discussions. Mostly people in the world are busy in different discussions. We have to solve our problem by discussions. It's very important. Discussions are very important. Nobody can run the system without discussion about any matter. We have to solve our problems by discussion. So discussions have great importance in our lives. In all over the world, people have to solve their problem by discussions. If we don't discuss, so minor issue can change the major issue. Next, types or kinds of discussions. There are some types or kinds of discussions. First of all, religious discussion. People have to discuss about their religions. People have to give logics and arguments. People have to convince the other person by logics and arguments. Most people are too busy about religions. People have to discuss to religions in detail. And as a discussion. Most people are engaged to discuss their religions. Other discussions, politics, people have to discuss about politics. Most people have to busy to talk about politics. Somebody favors to one party, the other person favors to other party. So people have to look busy in political discussions. Very common. Third discussion, domestic discussions. In families, if head of family, you have to discuss about problems with all family members. There are also discussion about youngsters in family. So head of family have to discuss about family matters. Many students have to discuss about different matters. There are many discussions among students, especially students have to discuss about their educational matters. And further things that I talk about, office colleagues have to discuss about office matters. Most people have to do work in offices and most people do business. So they have to discuss about their works, their businesses, their jobs. Most people are look busy in backbiting. It is also discussion. People have to speak against each other. We have to discuss with our relatives. There are different type of discussions, social discussions. We have to discuss about marriage. If there is marriage ceremony, so we have to discuss about arrangements of marriage. Same here, Allah forbid if somebody dies, so we have to discuss about mourning ceremonies, how to manage these things. So then we have to take part in many discussions according to situation. So these are discussions. I told you about it now. In meetings, in office meetings, people have to discuss about office matters. If there are current disputes, if your disputes take place somewhere, so people have to discuss their problems and they have to choose any wise man and settle their problems and issues by discussions. All matters are solved by discussions. Next point, benefits of discussions. First of all, people have to avoid from many disputes and quarrels by discussions. People have to solve their problem by discussions. People have to get knowledge by discussions. People have to solve their problems by discussions. People have to avoid from many complexities by discussions. People have to avoid from many misunderstandings by discussions. People have to avoid from many mishaps by discussions. People have to get success by discussions. People have to go towards progress by discussions. People have to clear minds by discussions. People have to remove their differences by discussions. Next, suggestions. If we have any problem or any complexity about any matter, so we have to discuss with the sincere people. And we should be cool-minded. If we want to solve any problem, so we should prefer to discussion. We should avoid from current disputes. If we have to discuss about anything or any matter, so we can avoid from current dispute. If we don't discuss, any matter. So most probably we have to start quarrels and disputes. We should act on teachings of Islam. All people have to belong from different religions, they have to follow their religions. In all religions, there are good lessons for human being. All religions give us lesson of peace. And how we can draw peace? By discussions, by dialogues. Our religions stopped us from quarrels and disputes. So we should act and follow to our religions. In that, my point of view, any minor or major problem can be solved by discussion in the world. It was revision. Yes, Bilal?
Yes, sir.
It was revision for you, and
yes,
you can perform well tomorrow.
Yes, sir, I will.
And you can speak. According to question, you have to reply me tomorrow. Also presentation for 3 minutes.
Okay. I will, sir.
We also join this class now, tomorrow, okay?
Yes, sir.
So, you have to flash up all things in your mind and repeat in your, repeat this in your mind. So, automatically, you can perform well tomorrow.
Got it? Yes, sir. Sir?
Yes.
Okay, sir.
No question?
No, sir. All things are clear.
Okay. You can prepare and practice at your home. And inshallah, tomorrow sharp 11 a.m. class will start. I will start your test.
Yes.
Maybe Shuyat and also the student colleagues can join this class. Got it now? Okay, Bilal. So class is going to end now. Okay. Bilal, do you listen me?
Yes, sir, listening. Okay. But sir, your speaks are not clear.
Okay, voice is not clear. Okay, okay. Inshallah, yes, tomorrow it will be clear, no problem. Okay.
Yes,
so
sir.
You need practice. Inshallah, we have to meet again tomorrow. Wish you good luck. Allah Hafiz.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Welcome.
Allah Hafiz. Allah Hafiz.